Hello students, very good morning to all of you. Today I'm going to discuss the second video lecture of class 5 of the chapter 3, that is our computer software. So before discussing, first of all I will introduce myself. Students, myself Deepak Maprosti from Modern English School, Kuntinagar, Nawada branch. Okay students, now students will discuss the second video lecture. Before discuss, remember the first video lecture. What have I discussed? What is software? Then why we need the software? This type of points we have already discussed. Today class we will discuss according to the user's instruction to the computer. The software is divided into three types. Software is divided into three types. One is your student system software, one is your system software, second one is your student utility software, second one is your utility software, and third one is your application software. Third one is your application software. Third one is your application software. System software, utility software and application software. Students, now first of all I will discuss this one. First one is our system software. System software. So student, system software is the collection of programs. The collection of program which controls the internal parts of the computer system. Remember this one. System software is a collection of program that controls internal part of computer system, internal parts of computer system. Internal parts of the system means inside the computer, or how it will be processed, how the data or instruction is taken from the user to computer. This type of the internal parts will be worked or managed by the system software. Is that clear? And remember one thing student, system software can never do to solve a particular task, can never do the perform a particular task. It is only used for the controls of internal structure or internal part of the computer system. Is that clear to our students? Is that clear? So that's why we are learning the word system software. Because when we are using the computer, first of all you what? Start of the computer. So when you start up the computer means the internal part of the computer is working. Okay. After that, what you are want to fetching, that is also it will be processed inside the computer. That time also system software is working. When you are switching off, shut down your computer, that time also system software is working. Is that clear or not, students? The students, remember, system software only controls the internal part of the computer system. No, it can never perform a particular task by the user. Is that clear or not, student? Is that clear? The student, what are the examples of the system software? Examples of the system software. The example is your what, students? Operating system. Operating system. This is the main example of the system software. Because the operating system is the main part of the computer, which is controlled the entire computer system. That means the operating system is interface between the user and hardware components of the computer system. remember this constant, interface between interface or link or link between user and computer. Remember this one. For that reason, operating. That means user gives the instruction to whom? Computer. That means in between these two, what type of link is there? That is the operating system. That means operating system we control from the user, and after it will be processed, give the information to the computer. Is that clear to you? That's why operating system is interface between the user and hardware components of the computer system. Is that clear to you, students? Then what are the function of the operating system? Function of the operating system, students. Then the file can never be stored. Is that clear? Then the second one, it helps to manage. It helps to manage the computer memory. It helps to manage the computer memory. It helps to manage the computer. Okay, that means why we use the memory, store the data. Yes or no? That means in the memory, not a single data is storing. So many types of file data are stored. Then how it will be controlled? How it will be managed? Okay, student. That means student. Suppose I am giving one very simple example. At your home, so many types of food items are there, and you have interested to take the food, all the items, but at a time only you take only one food at a time. You cannot take the all the foods at the same time. You take the food only one at the same time. So it will be controlled by our brain. It will be controlled by our brain. That means we have capability to think about that. Similarly, student, the operating system, the source type of the software or which can manage the memory. That means in the memory, so many types of data are there. So for to control that one, we need operating system. Is that clear? Then third one is your students. Then the third one is your. It helps to input or output. Okay, it helps to input or output to store. It helps to input or output to store data after processing. It helps to input or output to store. your data. That means for the data we give the data or computer will take the data. Yes or no? That means it is also managed by the help of the operating system. That means processing. That what you know, we give the instruction to the computer, it will be processed. Or what computer we give the data to us, we give or computer will give, both. First of all, it will be processed by the computer. That means first of all, after processing, that means it will be stored. That's why I am saying here it helps to input or output to store data after processing. After processing, data will be stored. Is that clear? And who will be done this one? Our operating system. Is that clear, our student? So student, the operating system is the main software of the computer system. If your operating system is there, then without any disturbance, you can easily do the work. Is that clear? So students, now we have completed the system software. Now come to the utility software. Okay students, next one is your students, utility software. Utility software. Students, utility software is also a collection of the program. But why it is a utility? Because by the help of this software, we can find out the problem from the computer system. Or suppose sometime we need, the size of the file will be reduced. For that situation, we need the utility software. Okay students, that means in the computer, it is our what? Mistake to think that what? Computer can not any type of the problem, or computer can never face any type of the problem. Computer can face the problem. That means computer will face the problem. That means user also face the problem. To detect that problem, why computer cannot run very smoothly? What will the problem that one? How to detect that? How to find out that? How to reduce the file size? We need the word utility software. So it is also a collection of program for finding out the problem of the computer system. Okay, and solve it. Is that clear, our student? And so many examples of the utility software. One is your student's antivirus software. Antivirus software. And second one is your compressor software. Antivirus software, students. What do you mean by antivirus? Antivirus is a collection of program, or antivirus is the source type of the software for detecting the problem from the computer and resolving it. Antivirus software is the source type of the software for which it helps to detect the problem and correct it. Or resolve it or delete it. Is that clear, our student? So that's why antivirus software is used. So nowadays, students, you are using computer, laptop, tablet. That means in your computer, after 1 hour, or sorry, 1 year, 2 years, 3 years, in some time, you can face the problem. Yes or no, your computer can face the problem. Is that clear? How to detect that one? By the help of the antivirus software. What are the examples, students? Is that clear? Example is a word. Quick A. Okay, student? Quick A. Norton. These are the examples of the antivirus. Come to the compressor. What do you mean by compressor? Compressor means reduce the actual size of the file to minimum. If you have created the file size 1 GB, after reduced, it can be 300 to 400 MB. That means you think how many
Let us, you have saved 600 MB. Is that clear or not, students? So that's why we need the compressor software. There are different type of the compressor software. What are the compressor software, students? One is your WinZip. One is your WinZip. Another one is your WinRAR. WinRAR. Is that clear? These are all the examples of our utility software. The students, in this way we have discussed. Is that clear? In this way we have discussed the system software and utility software. And one of the software is the application software. This one we will discuss in the next class. Okay, students. So remember all these things. Okay, students. Bye bye. Thank you. God bless you.